The Lok Sabha Speaker's post will see an election after talks between the ruling BJP-led NDA and the opposition broke down, even though both sides reached a consensus initially. While the NDA has picked BJP MP Om Birla as the candidate, the opposition has decided to field veteran Congress leader K. Suresh.
NDA versus India. The battle lines are drawn in Parliament. And it is the election of the Lok Sabha Speaker that has become the big flashpoint. On Tuesday morning, NDA proposed Om Birla's name for the post. Top BJP netas accompanied him as he filed his nomination. Hours later, the opposition bloc fielded K. Suresh as its own contender for the Speaker post.
The government is breaking the convention of the Lok Sabha. Speaker post will be the ruling party, then deputy speaker will come to opposition. That deputy speaker is no, they are not ready to give to opposition. That's why we are contesting to speaker post.
The opposition is clear that it will support Om Birla's candidature only if it is promised the deputy speaker's post. So far, there is no consensus on that.
पूरे ऑपोजिशन ने कहा है कि हम स्पीकर को सपोर्ट करेंगे मगर कन्वेंशन ये है कि डेप्यूटी स्पीकर ऑपोजिशन को मिलना चाहिए
का उपाध्यक्ष कौन होगा वो पहले तय करे फिर अध्यक्ष के लिए समर्थन मिलेगा इस प्रकार की राजनीति को हम की निंदा करते हैं और मुझे लगता है कि अच्छी परंपरा ये रहती कि लोकसभा निर्विरोध एक सर्वसम्मति से अध्यक्ष चुनता
तो ये जो आदान प्रदान करके ये पद ये पार्टी ले लो वो पद ये पार्टी ऐसा स्पीकर और डिप्टी स्पीकर को नहीं कर सकते हैं कांग्रेस ने अगर नामांकन भराया तो दुख की बात है क्योंकि स्पीकर पद को लेकर के आज तक चुनाव नहीं हुआ है
वी आर रेडी टू सपोर्ट स्पीकर सजेस्टेड बाय द बीजेपी और द गवर्नमेंट साइड Provided they should also honor the opposition status. When UPA was in power 10 years, all the 10 years we given deputy speaker to NDA, BJP. There is no problem for that at all.
The India Alliance claims the opposition has been insulted and that the Modi government can't be trusted.
अभी सब सामने आ रही चीजें जो विपक्ष की मांग यही थी कि उपाध्यक्ष विपक्ष का हो जो हमारी राय पार्टी की है वो है कि उपाध्यक्ष विपक्ष का हो और बाकी बातें अभी सब सामने
बट अनदर की एलाई द टीएमसी सेज दैट द डिसीजन टू फील्ड के सुरेश वाज टेकन बाय द कांग्रेस यूनिलैटरली
लेकिन अभी तक
कॉन्टैक्ट नहीं किया है कोई बातचीत नहीं हुआ एंड अनफॉर्चुनेटली दिस हैज बीन अ यूनिलैटरल डिसीजन
This will be the only third time since independence that elections for the Lok Sabha Speaker will be held. The speaker is elected by a simple majority. So the NDA has an advantage when it comes to the numbers with 293 seats. The opposition India Alliance has 233 seats. With Ashutosh and Piyush Mishra in Delhi, Bureau Report, India Today.
And we have some news just coming in. NDA leaders are going to be meeting Home Minister Amit Shah in Parliament. NDA leaders and Amit Shah to meet to discuss the election of the Speaker. Speaker election to be held tomorrow at 11 a.m. Himanshu Mishra is getting us more details on that story. Go back to him in a moment from now. But the leaders of the NDA are to meet the Home Minister in Parliament to discuss the way forward. Remember, there was consensus earlier, then zero consensus, a conflict. And now there is going to be, in fact, a candidate from the opposition side as well, challenging the NDA's candidate. Himanshu is getting asked more details on that. Himanshu, essentially, ye jo meeting hai, is par kya ruk rahega? किस तरह की प्लानिंग की जाएगी ताकि नंबर्स जो है वो इंटैक्ट रहे एनडीए के लिए ओम बिरला के इलेक्शन के लिए. कल है इलेक्शन और इसकी जो है स्ट्रैटेजी ये बनाई जा रही है.
हाँ देखिए बिल्कुल, एनडीए ये जरूर चाहेगा कि उनकी टैली है 292 की उसको कैसे बढ़ाया जाए और दूसरी तरफ अपोजिशन जरूर चाहेगा कि उनकी जो टैली है 237 की उसको कैसे बढ़ाया जाए. तो आज शाम को इंडिया ब्लॉक की मीटिंग है मल्लिकार्जुन खड़गे के घर पर और 5 बजे जो है गृह मंत्री अमित शाह के रूम में एनडीए के फ्लोर लीडर्स की बैठक है जिसमें ललन सिंह, जीतन राम मांझी, चिराग पासवान, अनुप्रिया पटेल ये तमाम लोग रहने वाले हैं और ये डिस्कस होगा कि किस तरीके से जो है वो भारतीय जनता पार्टी इस स्पीकर का जो चुनाव है जो पहले ही सेशन के अंदर ये कहें कि एक फ्लोर टेस्ट है सरकार के लिए अपनी नंबर्स को चेक करने के लिए. 292 का आंकड़ा है उनके पास, बहुमत से 20 नंबर ज्यादा है लेकिन कहीं ना कहीं भारतीय जनता पार्टी की कोशिश होगी कि 300 अबाव नंबर जो है वो इसमें जोड़े जाएं क्योंकि भारतीय जनता पार्टी ये बखूबी जानती है कि नॉर्थ ईस्ट में बहुत से ऐसे छोटे छोटे दल हैं जो उनके साथ आ सकते हैं या पूर्व में उनके साथ रहे हैं. 2024 से पूर्व में उनके साथ रहे हैं जैसे मिजोरम फ्रंट है, सिक्किम है, ये तमाम इस तरीके के उनके गठबंधन के साथी हैं जो उनके साथ अगर आते हैं तो उनकी टैली बढ़ेगी और भारतीय जनता पार्टी ये संदेश जरूर देना चाहेगी अपोजिशन को कि उनके संख्या बल जरूर बढ़ी है लेकिन एनडीए की ताकत अभी भी उतनी है जितनी पिछली थी. हाँ ये जरूर है कि इंडिया ब्लॉक जो है वो जरूर चाहेगा कि नंबर्स का जो डिफरेंस है वो कम हो जाए और वो भी ये जरूर चाहेंगे कि उनके आंकड़े ज्यादा से ज्यादा नजर आए और इसीलिए एनडीए के फ्लोर लीडर्स की बैठक अमित शाह ने बुलाई है और दूसरी तरफ जो है इंडिया ब्लॉक के फ्लोर लीडर्स की बैठक जो है वो शाम को मल्लिकार्जुन खड़गे के घर पे है.
जी बिल्कुल, मीटिंग्स ऑन बोथ साइड्स, इनफैक्ट बोथ साइड्स फ्रॉम द इंडिया ब्लॉक इन द मीटिंग ऑन द एनडीए फ्रंट इज वेल. हिमांशु शुक्रिया हमारे साथ जुड़ने के लिए. सो लेट्स टेल आवर व्यूअर्स अ लिटिल मोर अबाउट द इलेक्शन ऑफ द स्पीकर एंड द डेप्यूटी स्पीकर एंड व्हाट एग्जैक्टली देन डज द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन से. लोकसभा टू चूज टू मेंबर्स ऑफ हाउस, वन एज द स्पीकर, द अदर वन एज अ डेप्यूटी स्पीकर. द स्पीकर एंड द डेप्यूटी स्पीकर मस्ट बी अ मेंबर ऑफ द हाउस, दैट इज एसेंशियल. स्पीकर्स नेम इज प्रपोज्ड by the Prime Minister or Parliament Affairs Minister. The person is elected by a simple majority of members voting in house. Essentially, it is in fact the majority who get their choice of the Speaker. Speaker election date is fixed by the President of India. The Deputy Speaker election is fixed by the Speaker. Deputy Speaker is elected by a simple majority of members voting in the house. So why this fight really? Let's tell you a little about the role and powers of the Speaker, the final interpreter of the provisions of the Constitution. That's what the Speaker does. Presides over a joint sitting of the two houses of Parliament. Can adjourn house during absence or 1/10 of total strength. Also, cast his vote in case of a tie when the house is divided. Decides whether a bill is a money bill or not and his decision is absolutely final. Decides on disqualification of a member of the House. Joining me right now is National Spokesperson of the Bharatiya Janata Party, R.P. Singh is with us. Thank you for your time. Wing Commander Anuma Acharya, Spokesperson of the Congress is also with us. Thank you both for joining us. I want to begin by asking Wing Commander Anuma Acharya, what really changed? Because it did appear until today morning that the opposition, in fact, is not going to put up a candidate and isn't going to be a contest, really. Is there a sense of mistrust that the Congress has with the BJP-led central government? What is it that changed the decision of the opposition?
Good evening, Sneha. The origin of entire discourse revolves around having a deputy speaker from the opposition. It is an essential requirement for a democracy of accountability. And our Article 93 for the Speaker and Deputy Speaker of Lok Sabha clearly states that as soon as possible, the House of the People shall elect two members to serve as the Speaker and Deputy Speaker respectively. So Honorable Prime Minister, in fact, doesn't believe in a politics of accountability. That is the problem. And BJP, and especially Prime Minister Modi, is known for deviating from the main course, be it the issue of farmers' protest, be it an issue of when you ask questions on China's incursion on our territory, or scheme Agnipath, or GST implementation. He doesn't want questions to be raised. And everybody has seen 147 MPs have been taken out from the parliament because speaker of their choice. And from 2019, this is the first term in which there was no deputy speaker. So don't you think that for an accountability in democracy, for answerability, for more responsible governance, the deputy speaker is required. And that is where the crux of the matter stays. Right. So this is what is our thing. Our issue is they must have a deputy speaker established, deputy speaker also elected, but that is from the opposition's parties.
Okay.
So BJP government doesn't have a credibility because haven't they claimed that they will give 15 lakh rupees to every person? Have they given? No. They have talked about 2 crores job RP per
Singh.
Year. Have they given?
Okay.
No.
Let me bring in RP Singh. RP Singh today in the morning.
Double
when
farmers. There is no credibility. This is what is our basic point.
Okay. No credibility. You know, that's what Rahul Gandhi also spoke about RP Singh. The first thing in the morning that we haven't got a call. We said that we will, you know, offer support to your candidate. If at all you give us that courtesy also of letting us have our own candidate for the deputy speaker. But that call was not forthcoming. And that's the reason why there is mistrust. He spoke about it. Ki Pradhan Mantri kehte kuch aur hai. Or karte kuch aur is what Rahul Gandhi said. RP Singh, why this reluctance in having the deputy speaker in parliament?
Well, it's less of mistrust, more of politics. And more politics of one man upset. Mr. Rahul Gandhi, from the day one itself, I mean, he carried the book of constitution. He carried the constitution along and to show people that, oh, I'm with constitution. On the oath ceremony also, they carry the book of constitution. Although they have never abided by the constitution themselves, people who misuse the constitution, who
but the provision
the constitution
of the deputy speaker is there in the rule book. Mr. RP Singh, my question to you was, why the reluctance, why no commitment? If the opposition did say, you know, that you're not answering my question. I just asked you that when the opposition said, and there were enough indications that the opposition is supporting your candidate for the post of the speaker, no challenge, no contest is what they indicated. But give us our post of the deputy speaker. Why the reluctance?
Well, I'll start from where you stopped me. Today is 25th June, a black day in Indian history, in political history of India, in the democratic history of India, where constitution was thrown in dustbin by the Congress party. And it was my way and highway of Indira Gandhi, where he put more than 1 lakh people in jail, 10,000 political prisoners. So they have no
We're
right
not
to
discussing the
constitution.
Emergency. Mr. RP Singh, you're not answering my question. We're not discussing emergency. I'm just asking you, why the reluctance?
You spoke about, did you speak about constitution? Did you speak about that as mentioned in the constitution? So I was telling that they don't believe in constitution. People who don't believe in constitution, then they don't have right to show the book of constitution and tell what is there in the constitution. And also, there'll be a deputy speaker. Who's saying there won't be a deputy speaker? And there could have been a chance that deputy speaker could have been from the opposition. But had they, is the election on for deputy speaker? No, it is the election for the speaker. Because they want to play the politics of confrontation. They are not still prepared to believe that they are being given, assigned to a role of opposition, not of the ruling party, not of serving the people of the country. It is the Prime Minister Modi under the NDA, which has been given a chance to serve the people of the country, not Mr. Rahul Gandhi. But he's still in that mind frame that, BJP has lost election, Modi ji has lost election.
Okay.
So we will decide, we'll dictate. It's not going to happen that way. I mean, it's the number which matters.
There will
Today
be.
We have
okay,
number,
you're saying that you're going to let that happen.
More to that.
You're going to let that happen. The post of the deputy speaker won't be vacant like the last elections, like the last Lok Sabha, like the 17th Lok Sabha, where there was no deputy speaker.
Well, where did I say there is no chance of deputy speaker? This could have been discussed when the election for the deputy speaker would have come. But they want to show that they want to oppose everything, which every decision which government takes. So they are doing that, whether it was a pro tem speaker, whether it was a speaker. Now we have to understand that they are in that mind that they are the ruling party. They have been giving the mandate of ruling the country or serving the people of the country. No, they have to come out of this. They have to understand the reality. Reality is that they are 233, less than 240 of the BJP, less than the majority mark of 293 of the NDA. So they have to understand and appreciate that. I mean, they went to the extent of going to Nitish Babu's house saying that, oh, we will make you the Prime Minister. They were turned down because they are in that mind that, oh,
okay,
it's not the mandate.
Is this more about an ego clash? Anuma Acharya, sounds like it's more about an ego clash because, you know, just a couple of days ago also, the opposition did say that there should be humility as far as this government is concerned because they don't have the brute majority like they did the last time around. Where is that humility? Here, BJP is saying the Congress believes it's won the elections. That's not the truth. It sounds more like an ego clash than anything else. Anuma Acharya.
Sneha, not at all. You can see that BJP spokesperson is on back foot when he talks about constitution because it was not us. It were BJP leaders during the general election 2024. They started talking about changing the constitution. We all know there was one Hegde, there was Arun Govil and many others. They spoke about change in constitution. So when we started talking about safeguarding the constitution, that came as a master stroke, but not originated by us. We are the people who follow constitution, but they are the people who wanted to destroy it. And therefore, today, the opposition is much stronger. And therefore, the BJP spokesperson is like Modi ji, who doesn't have any credibility, despite being world's biggest democracy's prime minister, because he himself is not democratic. He doesn't play a politics of, he plays the politics of convenience, and he doesn't want any interference in that. And that is what we have to say, whatever they are talking about. They only do not want any accountability. They do not want interference. And therefore, the opposition is united together. We are, what are we asking? We are only asking.
You know, I also want to ask you this. Since you spoke about unity, you know, I Anuma Acharya, since you spoke about unity, your alliance partner, at least the NCP, the Sharad Pawar faction, is your alliance partner. Part of the India bloc has said that we weren't consulted. The Congress took a call as far as fielding K. Suresh is concerned. TMC, though not officially a part of the India bloc, but is seen, still seen as a part of the opposition collective in Parliament, says that we weren't consulted either. So, you know, there is a problem on that front as well, Anuma Acharya.
Yeah, Sneha, the beauty of our alliance is this. We know how to live within our differences also. And wherein we are talking about constitution, we are talking about deputy speaker's post, BJP spokesperson goes back to democracy, then we will have to talk about Harsh Semor, whose book, The Price of Power, about Mr. Morarji Desai, talks about his CIA connections.
No, Anuma Acharya. Also, you know, you also should answer this question. Why, how was this decision
CIA
taken?
Of Mr. George Fernandez also.
Okay.
And they, then the emergency was out of the constitution's provision for which whatever happened, whatever wrong had happened, Mrs. Gandhi during her lifetime, she has apologized from the country of, from the people of this country. So whereas BJP doesn't even apologize, last 10 years, this is an unannounced Hitler Shahi. Mm-hmm. Modi ji has become a Tana Shah, but they do not want any interference. किसी का नाम अगर उमर खालिद है तो उसको उठा के जेल में डाल देना. दिस इज व्हाट दे हैव बीन डूइंग एंड वी डोंट वांट दिस. वी वांट अ डेप्यूटी स्पीकर इन द पार्लियामेंट सो दैट द वॉइस ऑफ
ऑपोजिशन
इज ऑल्सो
एक्सीलेंट. यू हैव फ्रॉम द
सेरेमोनियसली टेकन आउट.
यू हैव फ्रॉम द आर्मी एयरफोर्स बैकग्राउंड.
अनुमा आचार्य, यू स्टिल हैव आंसर्ड माय क्वेश्चन ऑन द लैक ऑफ कंसेंसस.
शेम ऑन यू. शेम ऑन यू.
शेम ऑन यू मिस्टर
आरपी सिंह. व्हाट इज द पॉइंट दैट यू आर मेकिंग?
You people,
shame on you. You're talking about Umar Khaled. You're supporting Umar Khaled. You're supporting Umar Khaled. Shame on you. You have a defense background. You come from a defense background. And you support Umar Khaled.
Okay.
You
support the traitors in this country. You support the traitors in this country.
Both of you, please make your background.
This shows your new DNA. This shows your blood. You want a blood.
This shame should be on you.
Shame on you. You are supporting Umar Khaled. आप अपने आप को डिफेंस बैकग्राउंड से कहती हैं आप अपने आप को.
अनुमा आचार्य,
इतना कांग्रेस का छाप लग गया, कितना सोनिया गांधी ने और राहुल गांधी की छाप आपके खून पर लग गई कि आप उमर खालिद का सपोर्ट कर रही हैं.
एनी डेमोक्रेटिक सेटअप
one second. This
stronger opposition with the stronger.
No, no. One second. This can't be allowed. One second. You know, Anuma Acharya, I just asked you about consensus. Since you spoke about unity also, that but that question has not been answered. Just like RP Singh has not answered my question.
At the first go, I have replied your question that we know how to live. This is the beauty of our alliance, that we know how to live within ourselves,
they'll
with the differences.
TMC and NCP will come along.
Still
Anuma Acharya manalenge.
We want the post of deputy speaker for our opposition.
Is it difference in the dictatorship between the Congress and in India alliance?
I have already
replied
that.
No, this was something that was highlighted by the TMC
is
and the NCP when asked these questions.
It's all right.
It's a dynasty which is trying to do the India alliance also now.
Sneha, despite that, we all are together. We will keep on asking about deputy speaker's post, and that is a requirement of our democracy.
Okay. You know, RP Singh, I want to ask you, because today, just a while ago, you said, election nahi ho raha. You said, who said? Humne to nahi kaha, election hoga. Deputy speaker's election is going to be carried out eventually, is what you're indicating. However, the sense that we got through the day is that the opposition is hugely suspicious of you. And maybe for the right reasons, because the last time around, there was no deputy speaker. RP Singh.
Well, is there a deputy speaker in Telangana and Jharkhand? Jharkhand, both have the Congress and the
You're talking about state assemblies. You're talking about state assemblies. You're talking about parliament. 17th Lok Sabha was very different from
what happened in the
assemblies.
State assemblies are from out of the world. They're not part of the country. State assemblies are not part of the country. Our state assemblies are part of India, and let me name West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Punjab, Delhi, Himachal. Where is the deputy speaker from the opposition in the states? Tell me one state.
Comparing apples and oranges. There is the assembly on one hand, where both of you are citing examples. And RP Singh, my question is specific about what is the harm? Why not have a deputy speaker's position? The suspicion is that you're not going to allow it to happen. And that's where this... this disgruntlement is stemming from Rahul Gandhi's statement, wherein he went on to say, "Kehte kuch hai, karte kuch hai. Hame call aana tha, call nahi aaya. We were supposed to receive a call, and that commitment has not been, kept by this government. That is where the suspicion is arising from." RP Singh.
Well, did Rahul Gandhi made a call to Mamata Banerjee, Sharad Pawar and other alliance partners that we are going to pick up someone for the speaker post? No. K. Suresh has the speaker post? No. They don't have unity between themselves, and they are talking about call nahi aaya. They are talking about NDA part. I mean, let them be united at least in India alliance. They are not together in India alliance. What to talk about us? So it's a dynasty which is leading the Indy today also. Mm-hmm. It's a party, it's not a various political parties. It's one dynasty, which is Gandhi dynasty, which is so-called Gandhi dynasty. Gandhi. Gandhi dynasty, which is trying to rule the Indy alliance also.
Please, Mr. Acharya, please.
We'll decide whatever we need to decide.
Anuma Acharya. He's raised a question.
Name was Feroz Jahangir Gandhi, not Gandhi.
Oh, is this India Today channel or something else?
Anuma Acharya. Anuma Acharya, one moment. If you just leave that aside for a moment.
If
the pronunciation of a surname, can we just leave that aside for a moment?
You are lost to speak on a TV debate if you support Amar Khare.
I do support the purpose, the reason, UAP.
You support Omar Khalid? Shame on you. Shame on you. A wing commander, former wing commander of the Air Force, support Omar Khalid? Shame on you. You will support Yasin Malik. You will support Yasin Malik. You will support Burhan Wadi. You will go and extend your
The discussion is about the importance of the chair, of the speaker and the deputy speaker.
What is he doing?
You know, that's RP Singh, let's not get there, please. My questions to both of you were very specific. What is the problem if there is a deputy speaker, RP Singh? And my question to Anuma Acharya was that, because in politics and in life, optics matters. Today, the optics were as follows. The NDA collectively putting their weight behind Om Birla. However, when it came to K. Suresh, maybe a hurried decision, maybe an afterthought, maybe there could have been better planning on this one. But NCP, your key partner, was missing, and so was TMC from this decision. So the optics of this was that the NDA is together, but the India bloc isn't. Anuma Acharya, could this have been avoided as well?
Neha, that is what we are known for. We have different opinions, but we are together. We are together in asking for a deputy speaker. But look at the BJP spokesperson's language, where he's going. I am actually refraining myself from calling the most coward prime minister as most coward prime minister, and he doesn't want any interference. He doesn't want any answerability. Despite that, I see the BJP spokesperson.
Do Rahul Gandhi want interference? Do Congress want interference? They are not allowing Mamata Banerjee or Sharad Pawar to be taken on board. They are not taking Sharad Pawar and Mamata Banerjee on board by declaring a speaker candidate. So what are you talking about? Who's genocide?
All right. RP Singh, Anuma Acharya, there was a couple of things that stood out today. One was that the TMC and the NCP were missing from the decision that was taken, perhaps hurriedly by the Congress, essentially. Also, what really stood out and what stands out, and that's a question that remains to be answered, is whether, like the 17 Lok Sabha, will the 18 Lok Sabha get a deputy speaker, or will it be without a deputy speaker, just like the 17 Lok Sabha? We have to wait and watch what happens tomorrow and the days to come as far as these appointments are concerned. For the moment, I'm thanking you both for joining us with your perspective, RP Singh and Anuma Acharya, on that story that we are tracking. All right, let's now take a look at the top highlights of the MP's oath-taking ceremony in the Lok Sabha that continued today. Amid the emergency versus constitution debate raging in Parliament, Congress MP Rahul Gandhi took oath as a Rae Bareli MP. With the constitution in hand, Rahul Gandhi roared Jai Hind, Jai Samvidhan during his oath.
I, Rahul Gandhi, having been elected a member of the House of the People, do solemnly affirm that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the Constitution of India as by law established, that I will uphold the sovereignty and integrity of India, and that I will faithfully discharge the duty upon which I am about to enter. Jai Hind, Jai Samvidhan.
Samajwadi Party Chief Akhilesh Yadav took oath as the MP from Kannauj. Like Rahul Gandhi, he also took oath waving the constitution in his hands.
कि मैं विधि द्वारा स्थापित भारत के संविधान के प्रति सच्ची श्रद्धा और निष्ठा रखूंगा. मैं भारत की प्रभुता और अखंडता को अक्षुण रखूंगा. तथा जिस पद को मैं ग्रहण करने वाला हूं, उसके कर्तव्यों का श्रद्धापूर्वक निर्वहन करूंगा.
ईश्वर की शपथ लेती हूं.
डिंपल यादव टू कोट एज समाजवादी पार्टी एमपी. शी वन द बाय इलेक्शन हेल्प फॉर मेनपुरी पार्लियामेंट्री कंस्टिट्यूएंसी व्हिच वाज नेसेसिटेटेड आफ्टर द सीट फेल वेकेंट ओवर टू द पासिंग अवे ऑफ अ फादर इन लॉ मुलायम सिंह यादव द समाजवादी पार्टी पेट्रियार्क.
रखूंगी तथा जिस पद को मैं ग्रहण करने वाली हूं, उसके कर्तव्यों का श्रद्धापूर्वक निर्वहन करूंगी. जय.
Bollywood star and Neta Hema Malini also took oath as the BJP's member of parliament today. The Neta has been representing Mathura constituency since 2014.
भारत के संविधान के प्रति सच्ची श्रद्धा और निष्ठा रखूंगी. मैं भारत की प्रभुता और अखंडता अक्षुण्ण रखूंगी. तथा जिस पद को मैं ग्रहण करने वाली हूं, उसके कर्तव्यों का श्रद्धापूर्वक निर्वहन करूंगी. जय श्री कृष्णा, जय श्री राधा रमन जी, जय भारत माता की.
In a fresh storm in parliament while taking oath as MP, AIMIIM chief Asaduddin Owaisi raised the Jai Palestine slogan is part of his swearing in. This stoked a huge controversy with the BJP demanding action against the MP, Parliamentary Affairs Minister Kiran Rijiju says he will speak to the chair, while other BJP mantris have called his slogan unconstitutional. But the AIMIM chief is defiant of AC defended his slogan, claiming nothing is wrong in what he said.
نحمده ونصلي على رسول الكريم اما بعد فاعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم میں اسد الدین اویسی جسے لوک سبھا کا رکن منتخب کیا گیا ہے اللہ کے نام سے حلف اٹھاتا ہوں کہ میں بھارت کے آئین پر جو قانون کے بموجب طے پایا ہے اعتقاد رکھوں گا اس کا وفادار رہوں گا میں بھارت کے اقتدار اعلیٰ اور سالمیت کو برقرار رکھوں گا اور جس عہدے کو میں سنبھالنے والا ہوں اس کے فرائض اور وفاداری سے انجام دوں گا جائے بھیم جائے میم جائے تلنگانہ جائے فلسطین تکبیر اللہ اکبر
وی ہیو نو اینی کائنڈ آف اینمیٹی وتھ پیلسٹین اور اینی ادر کنٹری دی اونلی ایشو از وائل ٹیکنگ اوتھ از اٹ پراپر فار اینی آنربل ممبر ٹو ریز دا سلوگن پریزنگ اندر کنٹری We have no problem with any other countries, but whether it is appropriate or not, we will have to check the rules. Some members have come to me and complained about the raising of Palestine slogan at the end of the oath. We will see the rules first.
Sansad mein oath lete waqt jo Jai Palestine ke naam par jo slogan diya gaya, ye bilkul galat hai. कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के खिलाफ है. एक तरफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के नाम पर स्लोगन देते हुए दूसरा तरफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के खिलाफ ये स्लोगन देना और भारत में रहकर पालिस्तीना का गाना गाना बिल्कुल गलत है. आम जनता से अनुरोध करता हूँ ऐसे लोगों का जो रियल फेस मालूम पड़ते हैं.
All right, so now listening to what Oweisi has had to say on the storm over his Jai Palestine slogan.
अभी देखिए जिन्होंने क्या क्या कहा नहीं कहा तो सब आपके सामने है. सब बोल रहे हैं क्या क्या नहीं बोल रहे हैं. हम क्या बोले. हम जय भीम जय भीम जय तेलंगाना जय फलस्तीन. कैसा खिलाफ है बताइए. बताओ कौन सा संविधान का प्रोविजन है.
अच्छा तो आप कह रहे हैं आपने.
अरे सबने क्या क्या कहा वो जो सुन लीजिए ना.
सर आपने रिकॉर्ड हटाने की बात की जा रही है.
विरोध किया है जी किशन रेड्डी ने विरोध किया.
वो करते हैं उनको
कहा. वो ये कह रहे हैं इसको रिकॉर्ड से हटाना चाहिए.
इसको रिकॉर्ड से हटाना चाहिए.
बोल दिया अब क्या है.
All right, so Asaduddin Oweisi, MP from Hyderabad, has raised this issue, saying that how is this unconstitutional. He made that statement while taking oath when he said Jai Bhim, Jai Telangana, Jai Palestine, Jai Meem. And this has been raised by a handful of members of parliament who in fact approach Kiran Rijiju, the parliamentary affairs minister. Listening to what he said.
Nahmadu wa nusalli ala rasulil kareem amma baad. فاعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. میں اسد الدین اویسی جسے لوک سبھا کا رکن منتخب کیا گیا ہے اللہ کے نام سے حلف اٹھاتا ہوں کہ میں بھارت کے آئین پر جو قانون کے بموجب طے پایا ہے اعتقاد رکھوں گا اس کا وفادار رہوں گا میں بھارت کے اقتدار اعلیٰ اور سالمیت کو برقرار رکھوں گا اور جس عہدے کو میں سنبھالنے والا ہوں اس کے فرائض اور وفاداری سے انجام دوں گا. جائے بھیم جائے میم جائے تلنگانہ جائے فلسطین تکبیر اللہ اکبر.